Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Subtracting, Two-Digit Regrouping. Well, you will learn how to tackle subtracting bigger numbers with a technique called regrouping. Ready to master subtracting bigger numbers? Let's go! First, let's refresh your memory about place value. I know, you know this already, but trust me, it's important when we get to harder subtraction. So let's take a look at number 46. Do you remember which is the tens and which is the ones? Correct. The six is in the ones place and the four is in the tens place. The four really is worth 40, because it is in the tens place, standing for four tens. Four tens equals 40. Be sure to watch our videos on place value to go into more detail. Great! Now that we have your brain in the right place, value mode, let's continue. Okay, take a look at the problem here. Notice it is written neatly with the place values lined up. Just like in addition, this is very important in two-digit subtraction. Graph paper can be really useful in helping you keep the numbers lined up. Notice the six ones from 46 is lined up perfectly with the three ones in 23. The same can be seen with the tens place. The four tens, or 40, is lined up with the two tens, or 20. We subtract from right moving left, or from the smallest place value, the ones, to the largest place value. In this case, it is the tens. Let's subtract the ones place in our problem. Six ones minus three ones is three ones, while the three under the subtraction line, and remember to keep it lined up with the ones place. Moving on to the tens place, subtract four tens minus two tens, which equals two tens. Write the 2 under the subtraction line and remember to keep it lined up with the ones place. The end result is 2 tens and 3 ones, or 23. How about you try one on your own? Try 68 minus 57. Pause the video and see if you get the correct answer. Did you get 11? Great! Seems pretty simple. But what happens when you run into this situation? When you go to line up the ones and tens, you may notice there are two ones in 32 and nine ones in 19. There are not enough ones in 32 to subtract the nine ones in 19. Should you panic and run away? No, of course not. Remember when I said we need to review place value? Your knowledge of place value will save the day and make this subtraction problem a snap. Since 32 doesn't have enough ones in the one place, we can borrow or regroup. We are going to group the place value in the number 32 in a different way. Take a look at the problem again. We can take some of the tens from the tens place in the number 32. The 3 is really 3 tens, or 30, remember? It has plenty of ones we can use. So let's borrow in chunks of 10 since it's in the tens place. Cross the 3 out and write a 2 on top of it. That way we know we have regrouped and borrowed one set of 10, or 10 ones. Now, where do we put those 10 ones? Where we need them, with the 2 in the ones place. If we add 10 ones with 2 ones, we get 12 ones. Cross out the 2 and write 12 above it. Now we can subtract because we've regrouped enough ones in order to subtract the 9. 12 ones minus 9 ones is 3 ones. We write the answer 3 under the subtraction line in the ones place. When we go to the left to tackle the tens place, we still have enough tens, 2 tens, to subtract the 1 ten from the 19. 2 tens minus 1 ten is 1 ten. We write the 1 under the subtraction line. How about you try one on your own? Try 44 minus 29. Pause the video and see if you get the correct answer. Did you get 15? Great! You've got it now! You can subtract two-digit numbers even if the ones place doesn't have enough ones to do so. And you didn't even run away! Keep practicing our online games and quizzes, watch more videos, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.